mambo ambayo yanayotendeka katika dunia. Bwana Yesu apewe sifa. Haleluya. Yaani ile mambo iko katika dunia siku hizi ni mambo ya kushangaza na ni mambo ambayo yanatuondia mambo mengine, yanatuonyesha kwamba we are in the last days. Amen. Tuko katika nyakati za mwisho, na kwa hivyo ni nyakati ambazo watu wa Mungu tunastahili sisi kuwa waamka na tuweze kukua tayari kujiandaa kwa sababu ya siku za Kristo. Haleluya. Amen. Na nilikuwa nataka tusome kitabu ya Mathayo, Mathayo 25 tuweze kujisoma mambo kadhaa hapo, na najua Mungu atatubariki. Biblia inasema in Matthew 25 verse 1, then shall the kingdom of heaven be likened unto 10 virgins which took their lamps and went forth to meet the bridegroom. And 5 of them were wise and 5 were foolish. They that were foolish took their lamps and took no oil with them. But the wise took oil in their vessels with their lamp. While the bridegroom tarried, they all slumbered and slept. And at midnight there was a cry, "Maid, maid, behold the bridegroom coming, go ye out to meet him." Then all those virgins arose and trimmed their lamps. And the foolish said unto the wise, "Give us of your oil, for our lamp are gone out." But the wise answered, saying, "Not so, lest there be not enough for us as you. But go ye rather to them that sell, and buy for yourself." And while they went to buy, the bridegroom came, and they that were ready went in with him to the marriage. And the door was shut. Afterwards came also the other virgins, saying, "Lord, Lord, open to us." But he answered and said, "Verily I say unto you, I know you not." Verse 13, "Watch therefore, for you know neither the day nor the hour wherein the Son of Man cometh." Praise the name of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, tunashukuru Mungu kwa sababu ya maandiko. Biblia inaongea kuhusu ufalme wa mbinguni. Nasema, the kingdom of heaven. Kingdom of heaven shall be likened unto 10 virgins. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Why virgins? Because the kingdom of God, watu ambao wanaingia katika ufalme wa Mungu au ufalme wa mbinguni ni watu ambao Biblia inaongea about virgin. Amen. Virgin means holiness. Virgin means righteousness. Virgin means following the command of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So the kingdom of God is like it. Yeah, you like it. For you to enter into the kingdom of God, there you have to be. You have to be holy. You have to be righteous. You have to be a virgin. And when you are born again, because kuna taa
Hallelujah.
Akupate ukiwa katika nuru. Akupate ukiwa katika mwangaza. Akupate ukiwa umebeba taa yako. Na inawaka, you are not in the dark, you are in the light.
Praise the name of the Lord. Okay.
That's why he gave you to prepare you for his coming. He gave you the light so that when he comes, he will see you when you will be in that light. Praise the name of the Lord. Yeah. one, the wise one, they prepared well.
Hallelujah.
May you be the wise one in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And may God help you to become wise, especially this last day. May the Lord help you to become the wise people that have chosen to seek the Lord. Even the days of Noah, that Noah, when God said it is going to rain, na Noah akaenda akasema kuna watu ambao walimjino.
Praise the name of the Lord.
They ignored the message of salvation. They ignored the message that Noah spoke. What I said, who would say, I tell you that he's not saying anything. These are the last days. And the Lord Jesus is calling the virgins to be wise, to prepare, so that when that day comes, you can be among them that are going to receive at the Lord and be with them.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible says, those who are foolish took their lamps, but took no oil with them. There are people who don't have the Spirit of God. And it is you, it is your responsibility to make sure that you have the Spirit of God with you.
Hallelujah.
The Word of God is the lamp to our feet. The Spirit of the Lord, that is the Spirit, is the one which makes the Word to function.
Amen.
Bila roho wa Mungu, neno ya Mungu, damu yako haiwezi fanya kazi. Bila sema, katika in the beginning, group, a church like this. Christianity, it is individual. You have to have a
Hallelujah.
Yes. Praise the name of the Lord. Yes. So that is the how when I challenge, like the one we are having in the world today, I'm bowing a sermon, a pandemic we should not go to touch. Then the true Christian, the true believers, it doesn't matter wherever you will be, they are going to maintain their close, personal, and intimate relationship with God. No matter the place they are.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the Lord. But those who are not true, those virtues, those who are think they are waiting the Lord, but they are not wise. Their people are not true.
Hallelujah.
It is now their opportunity to indulge in themselves in any kind of evil.
Hallelujah.
When I hear huku usherati, yani sasa wapati na pasi ya kwenda kanisa, huku sasa wanasema huku atuendi.
When they are persecuted,
now they can do anything they want.
Hallelujah.
Without realizing that the Lord is coming and is very near.
Hallelujah.
When they are persecuted. But today the Lord is telling us to prepare for his coming.
Hallelujah.
Do you need to verse 5? When the bridegroom tarried, they all slumbered and slept. But in the same yule bwana arusi akaweza kuchelewa. Wote wakasinzia na wakalala. Wanaisha wapewe sifa. Even the wise and even the foolish, all of them, when the same walisinzia na baadaye all of them kutambo wamelala. Kukutukia tu ni kumorota.
Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah.
Unajua it is a process. Hallelujah. It is a process. Then when kids are people, even when you backsliding, in a kujanga through the process is adore. You start slumbering. And then all of a sudden, na jipata sasa ni kumorota umelala.
Hallelujah. Well, let's have a seat.
So, when the bridegroom tarried, the all slumbered and slept. Ikakuwa bwana arusi ametelewa. Let me tell you, watu hawajawahi kujua ya kwamba Mungu, one day for the Lord is 1,000 days, and even 1,000 days for the Lord is like one day.
What is a mercy?
So, wakasema ametelewa. Amechelewa, wakasinzia, wakalala.
Hallelujah.
Then verse 5, verse 6, and at midnight, there was a cry made, behold, the bridegroom coming, going out to meet him. Kwa usiku wa manane, kwa sababu, sasa usiku wa manane, kukatokea, watu kukatokea sauti, kukatokea voice, kukatokea kilio, kukatokea watu wa kitakasa. Ukatokea kuna watu walikimbia wakakuja wakisema bwana arusi aja, tokeni mwende mkamulaki. Usiku wa manane ndipo mambo yanatokea, wakati ambao ni usiku kabisa, wakati kumeharibika, ndio unatokea sauti inasema toka, tokeni, bwana arusi amekuja, twende tukamulaki.
Amen. Bwana Yesu apewe sifa.
Then the Bible says, then all of these virgins arose and they dreamed in their lives.
Hallelujah.
When I saw parents. So, wakati, what can you malice here again? And the foolish said unto the wife, give us your oil, for our lamp has gone out. But the wife answered, say, no, not so. Let there be not enough for us and you. But you go right now to them that said, buy for yourself.
Hallelujah.
Now this is a location that umetokea hali ambayo itakuja sasa kuleta distinction. There is coming a time when God is going to bring a distinction where we are all the same. We are all here waiting. The Bible says, at least for all the brides, all the ladies, they fled the wife and the foolish one when we are slumber and what you are coming.
Hallelujah.
Like even one of the wise one, hata kama walikuwa wamelala, the difference between the
Haleluya. Bwana Yesu apewe sifa.
Hata akijiita saa ngapi, ni kuamuka na kutoka.
Haleluya.
Hata akijiita saa ngapi, ni kuamuka na kuinuka na kusonga mbele.
Haleluya.
Hata kama amelala, amelala akiwa tayari.
Bwana Yesu apewe sifa.
Today, even the death that we are experiencing today, it is very hard. Hallelujah. Corona in a beba. Amen. Cancer in a beba. Mambo ingine in a beba.
Praise the name of the Lord.
So we are in the midnight hour. Any time, any moment, you can just be God.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah. Amen. And that's why the Bible says that midnight hour, it is the time when deeds are not good, when darkness in the world, total darkness, in the midst of the night, kumekuwa na giza. Na hindi wakati kuna giza. Hindi giza tunaona dunia.
Hallelujah.
And hindi wakati ya giza ndio tunasikia sauti. Na hindi sauti ndio tumesaidi kuisikia sana. Inaosema ni wakati ya kati ya mwisho. Ni wakati wa kuwaste time. Ni wakati wa kujiandaa.
Amen. Hallelujah. Mpe Yesu makofi. Hallelujah. And the Bible says, then all those virgins arose, trimmed their lamps.
Who trimmed the lamp? What was Amuka? Waka trim. Trim the lamp, remember. In a time, when you are in the way, in the waka, who see you can pisa. But as that, in a moshi, in a ring, in a tap, a lamp to Navi to see you. In a tower, when you are in a paper, see you come in a tire, where the lamp, Mahali, is kind of. Nita, you go up, Amba, in my coffin. Wanabeba hivi hapa juu inawashwa moto. Kuna utambi ambaye inawekwa ndani inaenda kwa besi ambayo iko na mafuta hapa. So hiyo besi ikiwekwa mafuta akiwasha anaenda ndani akijimulikia.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen. So kwa sababu hiyo utambi sasa imechomeka sana, walitoa wakakata hivi imechomeka hivi iweze kutoa mwangaza mzuri.
Amen.
So walipoamka na kuja, they did not waste time, they just woke up. Hey, we have heard the voice. Tumesikia sauti ya kwamba this is the last time ya kwamba anakuja upesi. Now they can be, what am I going to do? I have to do something. You don't just stay there. Useme enemy okoka. Akija tu za wokovu mimi nikwenda. You have to do something to prepare yourself, to prepare your lamp so that you can, the light can be more.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Na hiyo ni njia moja ya kutubu. The Bible says, hiyo kutrim your lamp is whereby you search yourself. You search your heart. Allow the Spirit of God. Allow the light of God to shine in your life, in your heart, so that aweze kukurithiria, aweze kukuonesha sehemu fulani ambazo unastahili kufanya marekebisho.
Hallelujah.
Bwana Yesu apewe sifa. Yaani wakati unaposikia na kwamba ni wakati ya kuamuka na kuweza kumulaki bwana harusi, unaamuka ili ujiandae kwa kupitia kutimwa ili mwangaze iwe mwingi. Roho wa Baba akumulikia. Naomba the Spirit of God, I pray that both the God and the Spirit of the Holy Spirit to shine in every one of our hearts and to reveal to us areas where we need to do some amendment now.
Hallelujah.
So hapa tutue hapa, Mungu amulike hapa, tuambia hapa hiko shida, tulekebishi. Hapa kuna hii, tulekebisha. Hapa kuko hii, tulekebisha. Yani Mungu akumulikie. You see some areas where you need some changes, to do some changes.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Waka trim your lamp. You need to trim your lamp. Kuna mahali kuna uchafu. Let's go pray.
Hallelujah.
Kuna mahali that ilikuwa ulilala. Ulilala, shetani akakuja akaleta akapanda something.
One.
Amen. Itoe kupitia kutubu, jiandae for the coming.